portions of my little morning routine. Honestly, I forgot how difficult it is to film a routine video. Of course, I want to get a bunch of different angles and like make sure I include everything, but I was getting kind of stressed. I was like, okay, how do I get this specific shot? How do I make sure I can show the cop? I don't want this video to be stressful. So I think I'm going to take it on a different approach now. I was trying to make it all like cute and aesthetic, but that's just not realistic. That is not my realistic morning routine. I think instead I'll just make this as genuine as possible, because if I try any harder, I'm gonna get stressed again. So hello, good morning. It is a Tuesday, and the reason I wanted to film today specifically is because I do not work on Tuesdays until 3 o'clock. So I have the whole first half of my day open for me to just do whatever, get whatever errands done, do whatever hobbies I want to do. And it's probably my favorite day of the week because of that, besides, you know, Friday and the weekend. I always try to take advantage of my first half of my Tuesdays as much as I can by, you know, again, fitting in some errands, doing some fun things. So that's what today's gonna be. I got a bit of a late start. It's already 10. I did wake up at like 8:40, but I just had a slow morning as I was getting up from bed. As you saw, I already ate some breakfast. I have my little Greek yogurt. I have my coffee ready. And now I'm just gonna take a bit more quiet time before I head out of the apartment. And I'm going to journal. So these are the two journals that I use. This one's my gratitude journal and this one's my regular journal. I write in this one almost every day. I sometimes miss a few days if I'm like just in a rush in my mornings, but I really do try to write in this one. This one's actually from my little Danielle. So shout out Danielle, if you're watching this. And this is more of like my traditional journal where I just write anything and everything. And this is also where my sticker collection is. As you can see, I'm really proud of it. I had to move some of it to this side and then we have some in the back. You can tell what I'm a fan of just based on looking at my stickers. In this journal, I tend to write in here. Ideally, I like to write in here 3 times a week. Realistically, it ends up being 1 to 2 times a week. I don't think I'm gonna write in this morning just because I did just write in it yesterday morning and I don't really have much to say today. I love journaling, but what I don't love is forcing myself to journal when I feel like I don't have a lot to say. Even though it's a good habit to have, I don't know. I just benefit more from writing in here when, you know, there is actually stuff on my mind or there's stuff that happened that I just wanna document and, you know, I just wrote on this yesterday, so nothing really new since yesterday. I'm definitely gonna write in this, and the way I format this, here is the way I format this. This is my one from yesterday, so I start off with 3 gratitudes, 2 ways to make today great, and then an affirmation. It really just helps, you know, add that mentality of like positivity to start your day, and it is very therapeutic. I like that this is like the one constant in my mornings. Like the gratitudes that I write could be, it could be anything. It could be like on a big scale or a small scale. It could be the fact that my coffee tasted good this morning, which honestly I might write down because my coffee is good this morning. And yeah, I think just appreciating even the small things just really sets the tone for my day and makes me appreciate stuff throughout the rest of the day. I'm not gonna ramble too much. I'm gonna go ahead and write in this. And then after my little journaling sesh, I was thinking about reading. This is the book I'm currently reading. It is book 2 of Chaos Walking. I'll talk about it more later. But I actually don't think I'm gonna read this morning. I think since it's already 10, after I do this for about like 5-10 minutes, I'm gonna get ready to go on a walk at the park. So that's the plan right now. All right, let me stop talking and let me write. Can you tell what school my husband goes to? Okay, so I'm ready to go outside. Got my biker shorts on, running shoes, and I think instead of just walking, I might go on like a little run or jog walk. I think I'm feeling that today because the weather's supposed to be super nice and I feel like I would feel really good about it if I did that this morning. The thing with running is I used to like have way better running stamina
like 2 years ago, and then I just stopped running. And now whenever I go running, I feel like crap. I feel like I'll never be able to have the same stamina again. Like I feel so weak, but I know that if I just keep pushing with time, that I'll be able to gain back that same stamina. So I need to chill out and stop being so hard on myself. I'm gonna grab my purse and stuff and pop it into my car before I walk to the park because right after my run, I'm gonna go to Sam's Club and Walmart to get a few little groceries that we're out of. Wonder Canyon Road's going nowhere. Cell reception's gone, we're really out here. Park my car in the drive, shift to low gear. What's that sound from my wheel and why can't I steer? Flat tire.
Tried. I jogged / walked for 20 minutes and it was so hard. But the weather feels good. I feel like I didn't even run half of it. Or maybe I did. I don't know. But literally every time I did try and jog, like I had to stop really soon because like my legs were hurting or like I was just like I felt it in my chest. So I definitely need to work on my stamina. Oh, there's a bug, there's a bug. Don't want any bugs on me. This is the view. Just enjoying the nice sunlight before I can run some errands. Feels really nice outside, even though I'm sweating. That's just because I'm out of shape. Look at that little duck. Is that a swan? No, that's a duck. Swans are over there. I think he's searching for some food. It came closer. Hello, Becky. Oh my gosh. We're back. I did not vlog while at the store because when I vlog at a store, I just get very overwhelmed. Like, I got one mission and one mission only, to get the stuff, go to checkout, and get back in my car. Because especially at Walmart and Sam's Club, they're always so busy. So I just get overwhelmed. But I wanted to do a quick haul, a little mini Walmart, Target haul. I had to have some willpower in Walmart today. There were so many things I wanted, but there were also necessities that we needed. But these are the two things I let myself get that I just wanted. Look at these little cups. These are like the cups that are so in right now with like the ribbed. But the nice thing is they're plastic. They won't break and they were only $2 each. So y'all sleeping on Walmart if you're not looking at Walmart's home kitchen stuff. Like they have some good stuff. These are so cute. And I can't wait to have my little morning coffees in them. Got a new scrub daddy. And then I also grabbed this because we don't have one of these where we can like clean the inside of our bottles. So I got that. Osiris because these are Caleb's favorite snack. I got new Polaroid film because we're going to Chicago this weekend for Harry Styles. And I wanted some Polaroid film to document the trip. These are the tortillas we always get. They're the Extreme Wellness. I think they're only like, yeah, each tortilla is 50 calories, which is crazy. These are my favorite energy drinks and Kale's favorite energy drinks. These are bubblers. They didn't have a variety pack at Walmart this time, so I just got the lemon lime one. This just tastes like Sprite. It's so good, and it's like 10 calories. Okay, and then from Sam's Club, these are the Chick-fil-A Duke Chicken Nuggets. So I'm actually gonna eat for lunch today. And then I left it in the car, but I also just grabbed a new pack of paper towels and tissues because we were all out. And that was the haul today. I'm gonna make lunch now. And it's almost 1. Again, I don't work till 3. So I think I'll fill up my time by, after eating lunch, I think I'll work on editing. I'm gonna put some of this stuff away, make lunch, and continue my little day. All right, I'm on my phone now while my camera charges. I forgot one more thing that I got at Walmart that I wanted to show you guys. I got this for the couch. I know what you're thinking. This is very college dorm of us to get a little bed rest pillow for a couch. We had another one here before, but I recently decided to get rid of it just because it didn't match anything. It was Caleb's. It had like a Patriots thing. We're still keeping it just for the memento, but
I wanted to get something else for the couch. So I got this little white one, and then we put the green one here. And then this I got from World Market the other day. It was only $10, so I was hype about this great deal. So that's that, and then here we have this side. Also got this from World Market last weekend. And I think the couch is like officially what I want it to look like throw pillows wise. The gray is still kind of offsetting with the warm tones I'm trying to go for, but I think the throw pillows and the blanket really just tie in the like warm vibe I'm trying to go for. And it ties in really well with the rug as well. So I'm quite happy about how the living room looks right now. And this was only 13 bucks, the little pillow. So that was a great deal. Go to Walmart, guys. I'm telling you, I am telling you. I love making these little chicken wraps for lunch because they remind me so much of McDonald's snack wraps, especially because I put ranch on them. So I'm really excited to share this with you guys. So the first thing I do is I like to add some cheese as the base so that when I put the chicken on it, the cheese melts a bit. I'm just using a Mexican blend cheese. Ooh, that was a lot. I don't need that much. We're gonna come over here to the chicken. And this is gonna look weird, but I literally cut this chicken specifically with scissors because I don't want to get out a cutting board. And it just works. Like, these are kitchen scissors. They're meant for use on food. So why not use it on my little chicken nuggets? Also, when they say that these chicken nuggets taste just like Chick-fil-A's, they're not kidding. And honestly, these are better because they're bigger. Like, you know how sometimes Chick-fil-A gives you like the tiny little bites? No. Now, usually I just put plain lettuce, but I have this salad mix. It's like a Southwest salad mix that is from Aldi, and I don't want it to go to waste. So I'm gonna use some of this to put on the wrap for a little extra crunch and some extra veggies. And this already has a little bit of dressing, so I'm gonna be using this Whataburger jalapeno ranch. This is gonna be probably hard to close, but I've been trying to work on my snap wrap skills. So you go like that. This one's way thicker than the ones I usually make, I swear. And then you tuck her in and you fold the little sides. I saw this on TikTok, and this is how Taco Bell folds their burritos. And there we go. Nice and compact. I'm contemplating whether I should have chips with this. This obviously isn't the most healthy meal, but also we got these pop chips that are not that bad for you. Like, they're 100 calories per bag. I think I'll have some because I love the combo of a wrap with chips. Okay, here's my lunch, got my water, and now I'm just gonna watch some Gilmore Girls. I'm only on season one. This is my first time ever watching it. Definitely sets me in the mood for fall. And as much as some of their conversations are pretty cringy, I still enjoy watching it. It's like a nice comfort show. So yeah, you can literally see my reflection. That's embarrassing.
Anywhere that you tell